summary of the story so that you would be acquainted with the things or incidents that are going on in the story, right? So first, a simple man finds the narrator, and narrator is asking and for a way so that he can come down and meet the simple man. Simple man at this moment is standing near the railway line, and he is standing on a high ground, okay? He asks for a way, and then he wants to come down to meet simple man, but instead of looking at the person or the narrator, simple man starts looking towards the tunnel. So this makes the narrator a little bit uncomfortable, that why, because I called him from here, and then why is he looking towards that place? So he calls him again, and then eventually when the simple man understands that he is in nowhere, he tells him that this would be a safe way to come down. Narrator comes down, and there we find that narrator and simple man, they both are sitting together in simple man's box, and then there is an expression of fear and sadness, grief on the face of simple man, and narrator understands that at right the time he sees him, or he looks at his face. So he asks for the reason, and then the signal man, the time they were having the conversation, he keeps on looking towards the bell which is there in the signal box. And he tells him, the signal man tells the narrator that actually, sir, I am extremely anxious, I'm extremely bothered because of a figure that appears every now and then. And it's not only because of the figure that I am, bothered or anxious or scared. And it is because the accidents that follow the appearance of the specter. And first of all, the narrator doesn't believe on the words that are said by the simple man. He doesn't believe him. He says that it might be your illusion. But the simple man tells him that, no, sir, this has not happened once. It has happened twice, and this bell that you can see, it rings before the specter appears, okay? And at that time only, the narrator asked him, sir, that is why you kept on looking towards the bell, and then he said yes, and it was ringing. And so the bell was ringing in a fashion that could only be heard by the signal man and not by the narrator, okay? So, and he tells him that whenever the specter appears, there is something, something wrong happens. So the narrator asks that the first time when you saw the specter, what has happened at that time? So he tells him that the first accident involved a terrible collision between two trains in the tunnel. It is likely that actually Dickens based this particular incident on the Clayton tunnel crash, okay? So let me tell you that this was the thing probably that inspired Charles Dickens to write the story this way. Because a Clayton tunnel crash, at that time Charles Dickens was also in one of the trains, and when he was traveling, the train in which he was sitting, and that got clotted with the other train, and so many people died, so many people got injured. Dickens himself, he was tending the people who were still alive but injured there, okay, on the spot, on the place where the accident happened. So he was impacted by this particular incident a lot, and probably that is why, like, right 5 years after that accident, he wrote this story, okay, the signal man. And later on, his son also told that he never recovered from that particular. That is why, because when you see people dying in front of you, that thing just doesn't go out of your mind. So the same thing has happened with Charles Dickens as well. And probably that thing inspired him to write this story. Okay. So he tells him, okay, the simple man, let's get back to the point again when we left. The signal man tells the narrator that the first time I saw the specter, there was a major accident on this railway track, The second time I saw him, and at that time also there was one lady, and she died mysteriously on a passing train. And I have seen the specter of the toys. Now the narrator is not ready to believe that. Okay, so he tells him that fine, probably you're not going to see the specter again, but he is sure. Man is sure that something wrong will surely happen because he has seen the specter again. And the most important thing about the specter is the specter always covers its one, its face with one hand this way and the other one is waved like this. And then he says hello below there, and he's calling. Okay, he's calling the single man. He tells him that something is approaching. Something wrong is approaching or is about to happen. So probably to save himself from the or to see something wrong. Okay, so he's covering his eyes, probably because of some approaching train, something wrong is about to happen. So he's covering his eyes so that he cannot see whatever wrong happens. And the other one is he's waving, the other arm is being waved by the specter so that he can grab the attention of the second one. Okay, so this was it. Summary of the story, and you are going to find a line by line explanation on this chapter as well in anime, right?